Hello students, I am Dr. Tanmoy Bishwas. I welcome you all in my channel Chemistry, the Mystery of Molecules. I hope you all are fine. So today we are going to discuss about a multiple choice question about carbonyl compounds. You can see the question in the board that this two reagent we have mixed under this condition, and the question is what is the major product. For this, to answer the question, four options are provided in front of you. Now you have to answer what is the major product of this reaction. As usual, I first request you please pause the video and try by yourself. Definitely after some time I shall explain, but in this way you can do the self evaluation for you, and I believe for a student it is essential. So please pause the video and try by yourself. I believe you have to pause the video and try it by yourself. Now let me answer you the question. So first of all, I shall answer the question step wise, and at the end I will explain within 30 seconds how to solve this question, because that thing is important for exam point of view. The first point is important for your understanding, and second is practice for better performance in the exam, which is the actual target of us. See, whenever any question you find, as usual I suggest you please read the question carefully. And whenever you do get any chemistry question, try to understand what is asked. First question in this case, what is the major product? Second, if a major product is produced, then the question is where the reaction will occur. That thing you need to understand. And second thing, I'll explain what are the options are there. So, what is the reaction condition? What it can result? See, in this case, this is actually a simple dialdehyde, aromatic dialdehyde. And this is actually this you should write proper way such that you can understand. This is glyoxal. Okay, this is glyoxal. Interesting point, this is actually 1,2 diketo compound. So interestingly, this glyoxal molecule and this is ortho-dialdehyde, better to say. I forgot the name. So this is, now question, if I ask a simple question, that is, which carbonyl group is more electron deficient? This or this? Question is obviously this one. Why I am saying? This means it is a better electrophile. So look at the reaction condition, aqueous alcoholic KCN. Now KCN, what is this? This KCN is a salt of potassium plus cyanide minus. This cyanide, see, there are two options possible. One, under this condition, this will undergo hydrolyze further to produce KOH plus HCl. Point number one. And second, there is CN minus. But see, hydrocyanic acid is acidic, I agree, but the medium is not enough basic, so it's moderately basic medium. So in medium, what are the nucleophile present? Cyanide versus hydroxyl. So this is not a good living group, sorry, good nucleophile, a unit. Now cyanide is a good nucleophile. Okay, why? See, because it's linear shape. And the negative charge is on the carbon. This makes it softer. So that's why it's a better nucleophile. Okay. So this is better nucleophile. So definitely that it will react. So where it will attack? Definitely on glyoxal. Here. This. So what it will result? So this will result in O minus HCl. See, the medium is aqueous alcoholic, not so strong. So this moiety could have been in equilibrium with the corresponding protonated version. So it can abstract proton. So what it will result after abstraction? This is CHO, this is COH, this is CN, and this is H. Now what can happen? See, this moiety attached to oxygen, attached to carbon, nitrogen, triple bond. Consequently, what happens? And additionally, most importantly, it attached to another carbon oxygen double bond. Okay. So this now this proton became sufficiently acidic that under this condition, means this weakly basic condition, this proton could be obstructed and it may result in this minus, which is stabilized by point number one cyano, minus I and minus R, point number two OH by minus I effect, and point number three carbonyl. So point number three is carbonyl minus I and minus R. In this way, this is stabilized. I guess you have understood this till now, this discussion. This is nothing but an example of benzoin condensation. Okay, why I didn't say it till now? Because I wanted to check how much you remembered. Because this chemistry I have already discussed. Actually, exactly, I will make a very soon a video about benzoyl condensation, but this thing I have discussed during the set of reactions. So now, question is, so this is nucleophilic. Till now, this I understood. So, where this nucleophile can attack? We know that it attacks an another carbonyl group. So, another carbonyl group of this glyoxal or this. Just remember, this is a very reactive molecule. So, it is expected all the glyoxal will be converted into this carbonyl. Okay? And although this glyoxal has another carbonyl group, but this carbonyl group is not that much electron deficient. Why? Because of this canonical form. See, O minus, this is H double bond, COH, CN. Okay, so this is actually the resonance, minus R effect of carbonyl group. So, this becomes that this center is not that much electron deficient, so nucleophile cannot attack here. Consequently, what is the option left? The option on left only is benzaldehyde. Okay. So, this. Now, it will attack. Okay. So, if it attacks, what it will result? Actually, this is a nucleophilic addition. This is a nucleophilic addition on this carbonyl group. And another thing. This aromatic 1,2 dialdehyde, it is not that much so electron deficient, not that much electron rich. Because first of all, this is in conjugation, second it's a dialdehyde, electron neutral. So it will open. So what it will result? It will result, this is the O minus. This is carbonyl attached to OH. CN, second, this is double bond OH, and this is the another carbonyl group. Now, see, this medium contains aqueous alcoholic, so this could be OH. Similarly, in equilibrium, okay, by the way, look at this. This is nothing but the cyanide addition on carbonyl, means you may consider in this way that it can be converted into anion and it can push, it can leave. So, what it will result? So, this will result this OH, double bond O, this is CHO. Okay. Now, see, still this is 1,2 dialdehyde. Still, actually previously that was, sorry, not 1,2 dialdehyde. This is aldehyde and ketone. Previously, it was 1,2-dialdehyde, very reactive. Now, in the reaction medium, this is there and this is very reactive. Okay. So, similar way, using multiple number of steps, what it can result? Same mechanism could be followed to prepare. This is double bond O. This is OH. This is O. By the way, now, nucleophilic attack will happen on aldehyde by the cyanide anion. Why? First of all, the bulkness of the aldehyde is less compared to ketone. Point number one. Second, see, this carbonyl could be in enol form with this. So, actually, there could be an equilibration mixture. For carbonyl may be here, may be here. So, this carbonyl electron deficiency is not that much strong. And second, The bulkiness of aldehyde is lesser compared to ketone, which is explained by a factor named Bargy-Lewis trajectory, which I have already explained in a video. Please visit. It's very important from basic chemistry point of view. Okay. So ultimately, what it will result that in this case, at this position, what will be produced? This is OH, this is CN, and this is minus. Similar way, this. Similarly, okay. So OH, CN, and minus. Fine. So this thing can act as a nucleophile and attack here, and it will be open up. So ultimately, what it will result after this open up? There will be a bond formation, means this, and there will be OH. After that, similar way, this O minus can push and CN will leave. So ultimately, what this step will result? This is hydroxyl, this is this. Now question, if you have this molecule, will it remain in keto form or will it will be converted into corresponding enol form? Means better to say in this way. Just this CM joint. So what is the expected structure of the product? The expected structure is, this is one hydroxyl, this is one hydroxyl, and this will be converted into enol because there are two hydrogens at this position. So enol means double bond, this, this. By the way, why 4 enol? Because the corresponding enol form is conjugated and resonance stabilized because of aromaticity. Okay, so that is the advantage of this enol. So this is, and secondly, if you think about the keto, means if you look at the keto form, see there is one to dipolar interaction. So, and it's a cyclic thing, so it can twist itself. So one to dipolar interaction will make this keto form more, means relatively more unstable. So in order to gain stability, it will be converted into this form. Okay, so this is the overall justification about this. Now, some other two options I have given. One was the Cannizzaro reaction of glyoxal, means one is CH2OH, another is COOH. But see, this is KCN, not concentrated KOH. For Cannizzaro reaction, we know that concentration of base need to be higher. Like if you compare this thing with aldol, Cannizzaro needs stronger base concentration. Not possible here. And one option was the Cannizzaro of this. That is also not possible. Strong. So only two options left. Product and another thing, one to diketo carbon. But from mechanism, you understood that this is not possible. So reaction will remain. So ultimately, structure of the product will be this. This is a very interesting compound. Okay. So this is our end of discussion. Now, let's discuss how to solve this question within 30 seconds. Okay. So you got this question. And it is given. So you need for this purpose, first of all, you need to knowledge about benzoin condensation, name reaction. I have already discussed. I'll make future video about it. So this is KCN, cyanide. So benzoin condensation, where cyanide will attack. This is versus this. This is more electron deficient. This means glyoxal. So when you look at a molecule, its chemical structure must be in your mind. That's why you need to first study, second do practice. Then you will be able to do. So this is cyanide will attack, okay, fine. But in this way, it will generate a nucleophile, means this carbonyl, benzoin condensation is the Unpolong reaction, means inverse of polarity of this carbonyl carbon. It is previously delta plus, but after this, it will be delta minus. Question, where it will attack? Definitely here. And if it attacks here, ultimately first attack, second similarly with this, ultimately result a particular product. Let's accept that you can't do that much so fast in the exam. Then how to use your mind? First of all, you have to look at the options. From understanding, from this KCN thing, you can understand that Cannizzaro are not possible. So first two options gone. Second two options given that along with benzene, there is a six member ring. Okay. So from the six member ring, you can understand if this is at these attacks here, what it will result? First of all, here hydroxyl, because benzoin condensation results alpha hydroxycarbonyl. So here hydroxyl, there carbonyl. Similarly, there is another, so there hydroxyl, here carbonyl. So only one option possible, where four hydroxyls are, another thing is the conjugated system, so four hydroxyl. You don't need to think about even the other option. This is a use of common sense. And generally what I observe for students, that they become so much tensed, confused, that they say that, sir, my brain was not working, I could not do. But that's why it is highly desirable that prepare yourself. How you can do? First of all, read the name reaction. Second, not only me, wherever you found MCQ, first see the question, try by yourself, check your knowledge level, how much time you need to solve, and say after that, watch those lectures. For example, here I am uploading these lectures and practice. And not only watch, whenever you are watching something, along with watching, write it on the paper. Then your brain will remember it as a photographic memory. So whenever you see this question, you can solve within less than 30 seconds also. That's the main criteria to crack the exam, to attempt all the majority of questions within proper time. Okay? So I believe this is useful for you. This is the end of this discussion. Thanks for watching. If you really like my teaching, so please subscribe my channel Chemistry the Mystery of Molecule, and please press the bell icon to get the notification of every single video I upload. Secondly, pass this video to your friend such that they can also enjoy the benefits. And most importantly, for my satisfaction, please like the video and make some good comments if you want to get such kind of video again and again. So thank you again. Stay happy, stay blessed. God bless you.